Hello everybody, in this series of my training videos I want to talk about VMware vSphere distributed switch structure and configuration. VDS has a central role for distributed managing all aspects of network configuration in every ASXi host that are associated with that VDS. In the vSphere environment, every vSwitch has two main sections, called management plane and data plane. Standard vSwitches have both of them together, so each of them has been configured separately. But about the distributed vSwitch, there is an architectural separation. The management plane, as the central controlling structure, belongs to vCenter server functionalities, but the data plane resides on each ESXi host. So the vCenter is responsible for creating and setup of VDS, but other network transmit and operation will handle by hosts themselves. So let's begin to install first vSphere distributed switch. I want to call it SDDC Software Defined Data Center VDS vSphere distributed switch 1. And then to choose version of VDS, you must attention to supported features in each version that may you required in the virtual networking infrastructure. So check each version's features accurately. For example, Mac learning feature only supported in version 6.6.0. In third step, we can create a default distributed port group called DVUplinks2 as the first port group in the VDS, but I don't want to set up here, so I need to check it. Specifying a state of NIOC network IO control feature and configuring total number of VDS uplink will be done here too. Remember, it will apply to each host, so if I choose 3 uplinks, each host that are connected to VDS has only 3 uplink. Then if you check and ready for complete, you can finish this wizard. Okay, now let me draw a best practice overview for the vSphere distributed switch uplinks. It's always recommended to associate at least 2 uplinks for virtual machines traffic, for load balancing generated network transmits, and keeping VMs available if one uplink failed. And one single port for management transmit, include VM kernel handling, vMotion, and etc. is enough, but if there is no restriction for the safety of host management, you can associate another port as its redundant standby uplink. Fault tolerance logging is also another important traffic in virtual environment, so strongly recommended to consider separate uplinks for this one because of its high transfer rate. And at last, for other important traffic, especially for communicating with network-based storages like iSCSI or NFS, you can assign another dedicated ports as their uplinks. Okay, now let's check some setting of created VDS. You can do all related monitoring tasks here, include checking issues, events, alarms, and health states. So you can edit them here again, name of VDS and uplink names. Just remember, if you assign your host uplink to VDS and then renamed uplinks, you will lose your connectivity, so be careful. If you want to change their names, do it before final association with host physical ports. I change them like VMNIC's default names. Like VSS, we can change MTU size if you need to enable jumper frames. Basic multicast filtering for grouping based on generated MAC address from last 23 bits of IPv4 address, or you can select
multicast traffic forwarding based on IGMP or MLD protocol. Then you can choose discovery protocols, for example, Cisco CDP and its operating states. You can choose listen, advertise, or both states. In the end, you can set contact information of network virtual infrastructure administrator. Other tab. For example, permissions include granted or inheritance permissions. Network tab also include distributed port groups and uplink port groups. You can monitor and edit DV uplinks attributes too. Also, you can see port binding states and VLAN trunk range here. In edit setting, you can set port policy includes vendor configuration and NetFlow settings. And you can configure reset at disconnect for situation when a distributed port is disconnected from a VM and you need to specify port, revert back to distributed port group settings or not. Also set either range of supported VLAN for trunking. And as you see, its default range is 0 until the 494. For some monitoring purposes, you can enable or disable NetFlow feature to work. And finally, in the miscellaneous tab, you can set port blocking on this port group. Now you can see configured properties of DV uplink port group. I will review other operations like creating new distributed port groups and or update its version on other videos from this series. Okay, finally it's done. You can review your vSphere distributed switch configuration. I hope it's gonna be helpful for you all. Do not forget to subscribe if you enjoyed. Until the next video, goodbye.